Roll the bumper. What's up, everybody? Claudio here, and welcome to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be walking you through how to use the audio duck feature or tool in Adobe Rush. If you're not familiar with what audio ducking is, it's the process in which the software automatically adjusts an audio track level so you can hear a different audio track. So without any further ado, let's go ahead and jump right in. As you can see here, I've got a project already opened up in Rush. I've got several clips here. I've got a vlog that I shot a while back, and this is myself here talking, and then it changes to another clip of myself going upstairs, and then it transitions to, again, myself kind of talking to the camera. I've added a music track here, as you can see in the green. Now, one of the cool things about Rush is you can actually have three additional audio tracks, and then the audio that's already included with the video is still intact, so it doesn't actually take up one of your audio tracks. Really cool. Now, the problem here is when you add a music track in the background and you're talking, they're both at the same level. So if I hit play, you'll basically hear just the music and maybe a little bit of myself. The new house here. And this right here is going to be our living room and up these stairs. So the music is cool, but I can barely hear myself talking. Now, normally what would happen before this feature audio ducking is I would have to actually come down here, and I'm actually going to zoom in a little bit here to kind of show you a little bit of those audio waves. What I used to have to do was click into this audio track and then manually kind of adjust or clip those tracks. So like right here, I would actually have to come down to this audio track and then clip it and then manually adjust the audio level, and I would have to go through the whole video and do that manually, which was a task on its own and would take a lot of time. Well, I no longer have to do that. I'm going to be using the audio duck tool. So let me undo this so we can have the full track here. Let's zoom back out just a little bit and let's head on over to the audio tool here. So I've got the audio tool selected, and one of the things I want you to notice whenever you're using the audio tool in Rush, whenever you click on a clip, your, I would say, attributes for that clip are going to change. As you can see here, it says audio type detected. So it automatically detects, oh, there's some audio happening here. There's someone talking. And then if I click on the music track, it's already detected that this is audio. Now, this is one of the tracks that are available in Rush. So I just pulled it right in. So it should know that that's an audio track. Now we want to make sure and select the music track. Don't select your audio, because you can see there's no audio ducking choice available. So when I click on the music track, you see it shows up as audio duck. Now, if for some reason you import your own audio track and do not see that audio duck option, check right here where it says change type. It may show as other, or it may not recognize automatically that it is an audio or music track. Just come right here and change it to music, and then you'll see auto duck. So, well, auto duck, what does it do? Well, here we go. We're going to click on that, and you should see right there, boom, automatically the audio has been auto leveled, or I should say the music has been automatically adjusted. It was brought down so that you can hear me. So let me hit play again, and I should be able to hear myself with a little bit of the music in the background. The house here, and this right here is going to be our living room, and up these stairs, just like magic and just like that. And let me zoom out so you can see the whole audio or music track. So as you can see, the music track has been automatically adjusted up and down based on what the video clip above is. So here is myself talking. As I go through, as you can see that music track, then it comes up because I'm going upstairs. There's nobody talking. And as I come back to talking, the music is automatically adjusted. So it'll do that throughout your whole video. Your music track will automatically auto duck in and out of your video. Let's say you want to adjust the music. Maybe it's not loud enough, or it's too loud. You want to still adjust it further. Like for example, let me click here.
studio. As you can see, the drywall.
So let's say I want to hear the music a little bit more. Well, what I'll do here is make sure I select the music track. And if you notice right here, it says reduced by. So it's a reduction of 87. I look at that as percentage, or it could just be a number, but I'm thinking percentage wise. Well, if I bring it down to 72, and maybe let's see what happens. This should adjust slightly. Let's see. Let's expand that a little bit. Let me go down reduction by 22. So if you notice, see how that adjusted right there? Let me go back up to about 70. And there we go. So if I hit play again.
Studio, as you can see, the drywall.
Minor difference, but again, all you have to do is just make those adjustments and you'll be able to be satisfied with whatever you want. And that's a quick overview of how to use the auto duck or audio ducking feature in Adobe Rush. So the next time you are editing videos and need to adjust your audio levels, try using the auto duck. Let me know what you thought about this video. If you have any comments or questions about this feature, let me know by adding it in the comment section below. Don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe, click on the bell to be notified for future videos, and please do share this video with others. Thank you again for stopping by and watching this video. Till next time, be good to one another. Peace.